strongest possible terms this egregious display of hatred, bigotry, and violence on many sides. On many sides.
Strongest possible terms. And the ACLU says there were two sides here. Now, all weekend long, the media in this country, they were unhinged, pretending like they didn't know what the president was even talking about. They ran wild with a narrative that he didn't mention the groups by name, so somehow that makes him sick. He condemned what happened. He called out these groups by name. They don't pay attention to this part. Watch.
Racism is evil, and those who cause violence in its name are criminals and thugs, including the KKK, neo-Nazis, white supremacists, and other hate groups that are repugnant to everything we hold dear as Americans.
Hate groups repugnant to everything we hold dear. But of course, that's not good enough for the media and the left wing in this country. Now, a quick sidebar. Where was the media? What was it, 6 weeks ago? A Bernie Sanders supporter, one of his supporters targeting Republicans at a baseball practice, leaving Congressman Steve Scalise, the third ranking Republican in the House of Representatives, fighting for his life. The gunman had an assassination of Republicans list. Where was the media blaming the Democrats the same way they're now blaming Trump? But back to the topic of hand. So once again, after condemning these groups, President Trump had to explain to the press exactly why he didn't immediately jump to conclusions, like, for example, President Obama did again and again when things happened. Take a look at this.
Here's the thing. When I make a statement, I like to be correct. I want the facts. This event just happened. In fact, a lot of the event didn't even happen yet as we were speaking. This event just happened. Before I make a statement, I need the facts. So I don't want to rush into a statement. So making the statement when I made it was excellent.
Now, President Trump, really, when you think about it, he's right, and we need to learn from the mistakes of Barack Obama. Nobody, especially the President of the United States, should ever rush to judgment and make a situation work. President Obama did it numerous times in these high-profile racial cases while he was president, and he rushed to conclusions before facts came out. Take a look.
The Cambridge police acted stupidly. There is a long history in this country of African Americans and Latinos being stopped by law enforcement disproportionately. And that's just a fact. When Trayvon Martin was first shot, I said that this could have been my son. And we have to close the justice gap. How justice is applied, but also how it is perceived, how it is experienced. That's what we saw in Ferguson this summer when Michael Brown was killed and the community was divided.
Now, President Obama rushed to judgment in four high-profile cases. He got the facts wrong in the end, and guess what? It led to false narratives being created, lies being spread, like Michael Brown, hands up, don't shoot, and that myth. I've covered these issues in detail. Then there's the issue of the leftists destroying public property, tearing down monuments like we saw happening yesterday in Durham in North Carolina. Now, you can disagree with these statements. You may not like these monuments. By the way, you can fight politically. You can shout people down and say anything you want to say. But is there not the rule of law that needs to be applied here? In other words, you can go up so far with speech and say anything you want, but you can't punch, you can't beat, you can't tackle, you can't fight with people just because you hate what they're saying, even when what they say is disgusting. Interestingly, even the ACLU agrees with me and the president on that tonight. Now, the president also reacted to this issue. Take a look.
You had people in that group that were there to protest the taking down of, to them, a very, very important statue and the renaming of a park from Robert E. Lee to another name. George Washington was a slave owner. Was George Washington a slave owner? So will George Washington now lose his status? Are we going to take down, statues to George Washington? How about Thomas Jefferson? What do you think of Thomas Jefferson? You like him? Okay, good. Are we going to take down the statue? Because he was a major slave owner. Now, we're going to take down his statue.
Joining us now, author of the New York Times bestseller, we're now, 10, 11 weeks on the New York Times list, Understanding Trump, including number one, former Speaker of the House, Newt Gingrich. All right, I want to go over truth here, because And as somebody that lived in Georgia and the South and Stone Mountain and what's happening to these monuments, I think you have a very, very unique perspective and also the historical perspective you have. But I want to first go over the president repeatedly now for days has condemned white supremacism, David Duke, the Klan, and all these groups. And I watched the media today, and they go insane because he says, you know what? There was violence on both sides. Not all, but there was. And the media went insane because he said it. What's your reaction?
Well, first of all, everybody who went insane is insane. The American Civil Liberties Union, in their Twitter feed, and I want to give Joe DeSantis credit for tracking this down and getting it to me, the ACLU in their Twitter feed said both sides came for violence. They said the video you're looking at, you see people on the left who are being violent. You see people on the right who are being violent. The truth is, President Trump is telling the American people the truth, and the elite media hates it, and the left hates it, and he's going right at the heart of the big lie on the left. Most of the violence we've seen politically this year has been on the left. They're not putting a $9,000 escape door into the chancellor of the University of California at Berkeley's office to hide from right-wingers. They're putting in there to hide from left-wing students. The students at Middlebury College who blocked a conservative from speaking weren't on the right, they were on the left. So let's be really clear here what we're faced with in this country. And I think we should condemn neo-Nazis. They are an anti-Christian, totalitarian, anti-Semitic movement. We should be very tough on them. I think we should condemn racism. But frankly, I think we should condemn racism on both sides. And I think you have a very strong case here that there are people who have been out there advocating shooting cops. Those weren't right-wingers. So let's be really clear. There is more than enough blame on both the right and the left to say, we're tired of all of you. Cut it out or we're going to put you in jail.
Let me ask about the president saying, you know, he spoke out on Saturday. I read his tweets again. He spoke out on Monday. He spoke out today. He said it again and again and again, specifically naming them. And he said that he waited until he had facts. And I compared it to what Obama did. Obama rushed to judgment, George Zimmerman, Trayvon Martin, Ferguson, Missouri, the Cambridge police, Freddie Gray, Baltimore. Was wrong on all counts because he didn't wait for evidence, testimony, facts to come in. Was it right for the president to condemn the hatred, what we saw on Saturday, wait for the facts, and do what he did on Monday and today?
Look, I have to confess, Calista and I saw live on Saturday his statement. We both thought it was pretty clear and direct. And remember, this is a man who, as a candidate, repudiated David Duke, as a candidate, repudiated the Ku Klux Klan.
Again and again.
You know, and by the way, this is a man who in his inaugural address says to the entire country, we all bleed the same color. You cannot be a patriotic American and be a racist. I mean, he's very clear in... So I think he's starting out Saturday thinking, I'm going to add to what I've already been saying. And I suspect he was shocked at the level of hostility, including among some Republicans, that you had to be very specific. So he comes back and he's very specific. I mean, how can you be more specific than this? But then he makes the mistake of telling the truth about violence on the left. And so all of a sudden, the elite media has to go crazy again. I just think it's time to draw a line in the sand and say, everybody in this country who wants to lead a big lie, watch the elite media, watch the left-wing Democrats, because they represent a big lie. It's worse than fake news. It is a big lie.
Let me, you know, we both lived in Georgia, and we now have instances, and we have other cities, now Baltimore and all these other cities. You saw it in Durham, North Carolina yesterday, and it's like ripping down statues of our founders and our framers. The president talked today about, okay, yes, George Washington was a slave owner. Thomas Jefferson was a slave owner. Are we now heading towards a point, and he said it's up to the states to decide, where we are now going to watch history being removed from city after city after city, Is that where we're headed? For example, in Stone Mountain, Georgia. I know you've been to Stone Mountain. There is a carving on Stone Mountain. And you have the president of the Confederacy up there, Jefferson Davis, and others. And is that going to be sandblasted next week?
I actually asked that question in an email a while ago to a friend of mine. Let's be clear. I think it's perfectly reasonable for an African-American looking at somebody who fought to protect slavery to be deeply offended. Now, there's a huge difference between Washington and Jefferson and Jackson, who may have been slave owners, but they, in fact, were all moving towards a world that had less slavery, not a world that had more slavery. But there's no question, people who were fighting to protect slavery, to protect slave trading. And let me also say for the audience, I was born in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. I grew up in an integrated United States Army. I moved to Georgia as a junior in high school. So those people are going to say, well, he's a Georgian, so he's going to say these things. I'm saying him as a historian. I think if a city wants to take a statue out of the center of the city and put it in a museum, that makes some sense. I don't think we want to be like the Taliban, who were destroying Buddhist temples or Buddhist statues. I don't think we want to be like ISIS, which was destroying historic monuments. And you have a great deal of people on the left who, if they could destroy our entire memory of America, they would wipe it out, and we'd have no knowledge of what it meant to be an American. And we need to draw some lines in the sand.
Stay right there. We'll have more with Speaker Gingrich right after the break. Also, Laura Ingraham tonight. She'll weigh in on the president and firing back earlier today and all the issues ahead. Straight ahead.